I'm Dr. Anirudh Patel. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Psychology at Tufts University, and I study music and the brain.
If you could explain to the audience from a neurobiological perspective why musical training would lead to adaptive neural plasticity in speech processing networks and cognitive function.
Music is a very complex cognitive activity, just as speech is, and there's a lot of interest these days in whether doing music actively, that is, playing an instrument, learning to play an instrument, and playing it regularly, can impact the way the brain processes speech. There's actually evidence that musicians have better linguistic abilities in certain domains, like better hearing of speech and noise, better ability to decode emotion in the voice. Young children that study music seem to have some advantages in learning reading. And when I say I'm speaking of musicians, I don't mean professionals. I mean individuals that are pursuing music as a hobby, but doing it in a regular way. But the question is, why are these effects being seen, and what mechanisms mediate them? So one possibility is that music is exercising certain parts of the brain that are shared with language processing, such as areas involved in encoding the fine structure of sounds, such as pitch and timing and so forth, and areas involved in memory, working memory, so be able to hold sounds in memory as you analyze their structure and so forth. And it's doing this in a way that puts higher demands on those regions than speech does. And because it does it in a way that also involves rich emotion and attention to the stimulus and a lot of repetition, it drives neural plasticity. It drives the brain to change the way it processes sounds. But because some of those sound features are shared by music and speech, speech processing actually benefits. This is the core of what I call the opera hypothesis, which tries to explain why this counterintuitive relationship would exist, where training in one domain, music, would influence another domain, speech.
So if you could just explain to us about what the evidence might be for the relationship between musical abilities and
yes.
reading skills in children,
okay.
and why this might be helpful to
yes.
to provide some musical training in children with linguistic reading limitations.
Well, the evidence comes from two kinds of lines of research. The one is actually truly experimental research, and there's less of that. But there are a couple of studies that have shown that training young children, so these are 8, 9-year-olds, with music will result in greater enhancements in linguistic reading than, say, training them in some enjoyable but non-musical activity, such as painting. And so that's one line of evidence. I would say that's the best evidence because it's truly experimental. But there are also a lot of correlational studies which look at whether children that receive more musical training are also showing enhancements in reading. And for example, one study that was published in the journal called Reading and Writing in 2012 by my colleague Marianne Wolfe at Tufts and a team of those people showed links between, I think it was early preschool to first grade children. They tested them on rhythmic abilities in music and phonological abilities, that is, the ability to understand the individual segments of words and to divide words into their individual sounds mm-hmm. and order them and categorize them, were correlated in these children. And rhythmic abilities, I think, in the earlier group actually predicted how well they did in reading ability later on in school,
mm-hmm.
Independent of other control variables that they were measured by a correlation. So there's a number of these so-called correlational studies that are pointing to these really intriguing and surprising link between rhythm and in non-linguistic rhythmic abilities and the development of certain language-based abilities that feed into reading, like
mm-hmm.
phonology. And so what's needed now are more truly experimental studies that take this on and address it with randomized controlled studies and behavioral and neural measures to understand why these things would be related. Is it because rhythm puts strong demands on timing in music, and some of those same temporal processes are involved in parsing language? Is it more of a general working memory effect? What is it exactly that's driving these effects?
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, the second part of your question about the practical implications. And there, I think the practical implications would be to identify children that are at risk for reading disorders before they start to read, so around 4 or 5 years old, training them with music, and then seeing if that can impact their ultimate outcome in terms of their reading abilities.
But that hasn't been done yet.
No, that hasn't been done yet.
That's a study waiting
yes, to be
to happen.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.